means inheritance. Today concept name is inheritance. What do you mean by inheritance? Inheritance is the one of the concept. Today first concept inheritance. Inheritance. It is the one of the concept. It is the one of the concept. Provided by Java. Inheritance is the one of the concept provided by Java, which is used for extending the all the parent class stuff to child class. Inheritance one of the concept provided by Java, which is used for extending the all the parent class stuff to child class. All the parent class stuff to child class. We can extend the all the parent class stuff to child class. Here you should remember only one point, madam. A extends B. That means A extends B. That means B properties will come to A. A extends B means B properties will come to A. Or A can get all the B properties. So that is the concept inheritance. Only one sentence, A extends B. Just if you want to know this concept, more than enough. So here, you know, madam, Java, we will not learn entire Java, madam. So some basics of Java only we need to learn here. So just you should remember only one point. A extends B means B properties will come to A. Okay. This is the logic. Only for this logic purpose we are learning Java. So for example, I need Narendra Modi properties. How I can write? Tell me.
You will be the child class and Narendra Modi will be the parent class.
So and my name is Akhil, madam. Okay.
Akhil extends Modi.
Akhil extends Modi. That means Modi properties will come to Akhil. Okay. Akhil extends Modi. So just only for this, A extends B means B properties will come to A. Akhil extends Modi. Modi properties will come to Akhil. So right. So for example, here I'm taking one father class. I'm taking one father class. I'm giving two functions. One is earn. Second one is drive. One is earn. Second one is drive. He can earn the money. He can drive the car. Two functions I am giving. I am taking son class. Son, he can drink and he can smoke. Already father I gave and. So that's the reason here I am giving drink and smoke. Grandson. Play and study. So two functions I am giving. Okay, right. So before going to inheritance concept, yesterday we have taken only one class, that is the by class, under class. We wrote the functions and we called from main method. That is the concept is over. So in static properties and non-static properties concept, we have taken only one class, that is the by class. We wrote functions under the class and we called from main method. That is the concept different. But here is, if we should take father class, son class, grandson class. So, and we need to manage nearly four classes. How to manage different classes? So that is the first concept. After that, we can discuss about inheritance concept. So father having two functions here. Father having two functions. For example, if I write son extends father, what will happen?
Son extends father. Son will have the earn and drive functions also.
So that means,
A father functions will come to son.
so that means he can get to 2 plus 2. How many properties he can
Yeah.
get?
4.
4. Right. Grandson extends. Grandson extends son. What will happen?
6 functions. He will have
He
6
can get
functions.
6 functions. So 2 plus 2 plus 2. 6 functions he can get. So before going to inheritance concept, so first of all we should know how to manage different classes. So yesterday we have taken only one class and we wrote functions under class and we called from main method. So but here is inheritance is totally different. Here we need to maintain 3 classes, and if you want call the all the functions from another class, so we need to maintain 4 classes here. How to manage different classes today? First concept, how to manage different classes. After that we can discuss inheritance concept, right? Go to Eclipse. First we need to take father class, son class, grandson class, and if you want call the functions from other classes, so that time we should take main class. So we need to call the all the functions from that class, how we can manage. So that is the first concept we need to discuss. So right, and taking one class here we no right go to SRC, take the new class. Class name is father. I am taking one class, that class name is father. Only class I am taking. I am not taking any main method. Only I am taking class. I am taking only class. So here I am writing two functions. Public void earn. So I am writing one function. So I am taking non-static function. SYSO control space. Father earning. I'm writing one function, father earning. Okay, over. I'm writing another function, drive. Father driving. So two functions I am writing, one is earn, second one is drive, right? So save and go to SRC and take the new class. Class name is son class. Son. Only class I am taking here also. So I am giving two functions. One is drink, second one is smoke. Drink. Sun drinking. Next, smoke. Sun smoking. Right. Save. I'm going to SRC once again. I'm taking new class. That class name is grandson. Here also I am giving two functions. Grandson play and grandson study. Play. Grandson playing. GS. Playing. Study. Grandson studying. GS. Grandson studying. STU. Right. Have taken three classes. Father class, son class, grandson class. So I gave two properties or functions or actions. Okay. Grandson playing and grandson studying. Okay. So if I want to call these functions from another class, we should take new class, go to SRC, take the new class. That class name is in inheritance. So inheritance. Take any name that is not important. Just keep the mark. So if you want to call the functions from another class, compulsory we should keep the mark. So we can call from main method only. So that's the reason here I am keeping the mark public static void main string. So that means this is the main method. If I want to call the functions from father class, how I can call? Tell me, ma.
Sorry, what are you asking? We need to create an object.
How to create the object? I want to call the functions from father class.
Father.
I want to call the functions from
father.
Tell me.
Father equals to new father F1 equals to new father F.
Right, Shabazz, good. Father F equal to new father. Why? Because why we need to create the object?
Because it is not void class.
Not static. Non-static.
Yes, static.
All the functions are non-static. So if you want to call the functions from, if it is in the same class, if you want to call from another class, we should create the object. If it is non-static, if you want to call the functions in same class, or if you want to call the functions from other class, we need to create the object. This is the first point. If you want to learn Java, this is the first point you should remember. So I want to call the calls from, properties from another class. So that time we can create the object father f equal to new father. So now f dot n and f dot drive. Okay, next I want to call the functions from sun class. So then sun s equal to new sun. Sun is equal to new sun. S dot drink. S dot smoke. I want to call the functions from grandson class. Grandson g equals
yes.
New grandson. G dot play.
Play.
G dot study.
G dot study.
G dot play and G dot study. So this is the class. How to manage different classes. This is the concept. But today our concept is inheritance. What is the inheritance? Inheritance is the one of the concept provided by Java, which is used for extending the all the parent class up to child class. How we can extend the parent class from to child class? So I'm going to son class. Son extends father. Here I am writing son extends father. So what will happen? Father class function will come to son. So it is coming or not, just you can check it. So son having only two properties, but now he can get two extra properties, s dot earn. Yes, he is getting s dot drive is getting, right? That is the inheritance. So next, grandson. Grandson extends son. Grandson extends son, save. So grandson, he can get four more properties, like, you know, g dot earn, and he can get, right, he is getting g dot drive. Yes, he is getting g dot play, sorry, g dot drink is getting, g dot smoke is getting. So this is the concept inheritance. This is the concept inherited. Whatever your logic, whatever you mentioned logic, that logic will print in console. Father running, father driving, son drinking, son smoking, father running, father driving, grandson playing, grandson studying, father running, father driving, son drinking, son smoking. So this is the concept inheritance. Inheritance is the one of the concept provided by Java, which is used for extend the all the parent class stuff to child class. Just you should remember only one logic: A extends B means B properties will come to A. A extends B means B properties will come to A. That is the concept inheritance. Very easiest concept in entire Selenium and Java. That is the concept inheritance. Inheritance is the one of the concept provided by Java, which is used for extending the all the parent class stuff to child class. Okay. Oh. Next concept. Simple concept. Very easiest concept. Another concept. Second easiest concept. That concept name is overloading. Overloading. Next concept name is overloading. What do you mean by overloading, madam? Already you know some Java, so tell me, what do you mean by overloading? Do you know anything?
Overloading and overriding, two concepts will be there.
Overloading.
No.
You don't know?
Overloading and overriding. Overriding two different concepts
in Java, overloading and overriding. Overriding I will teach you in end of Java, but overloading right now we need to discuss. Why? Because no need to confuse, like what is overloading, what is overriding. That's the reason I divided totally. So first of all I will teach overloading, after that end of the Java I will teach overriding. What do you mean by overloading? Do you know anything?
No.
Okay. I will teach you. Don't worry. So overloading. What do you mean by overloading? If at all, very, very simple definition, madam. Whatever I am teaching, it's very simple. If at all, a function more than one time in a class. More than one time in a class. If at all a function more than one time in a class, if you write like same, if at all a function more than one time in a class, if at all a function more than one time in a class, if you write like different arguments, different arguments like number of args, comma, type of args, then that concept is called overriding. Overloading. If at all a function more than one time in a class, if at all same function, if you write more than one time in a class, automatically it will show error. But same function, if you write more than one time in a class with different arguments, like different arguments or type of arguments, so then that concept is called overloading. If at all a function more than one time in a class with different arguments, like type of arguments or number of arguments, so then that concept is called overloading. Same function, if you write number of times, automatically it will show error. But here I am writing same function in more than one time in a class with different arguments, like type of arguments, comma, number of arguments. So I'm changing the type of arguments or number of arguments, then the time it will not show any error. Same function, but I am writing with different arguments, comma, number of arguments, then that concept is called overloading. So it is very, very important. So if you want to learn Selenium, that time it is very, very important. Number of times we will use this concept, that is the concept overloading. If at all a function more than one time in a class with different arguments, like type of arguments, comma, number of arguments, if we write, then that concept is called overloading. Same function we are writing number of times. How we can write? So same function, if you write, automatically it will show error. But here I am changing the number of arguments, comma, type of arguments. That time it will not show any error. So that is the concept, overloading concept. So I will show you with the practical. I'm taking one class, that class name is O. Take new class, class name is O. Right, just keep the mark public static void, main, click on finish. Before going to this concept, first of all you should know one definition. Oh, I forgot. So what do you mean by variable? Do you know anything about variable?
We can store any data in between of the program, in between the program. Suppose if int a, and we can what we call we can give any value to that a. I mean a equals to 1 or a equals to 20,
Right,
any
good,
value.
shabash, 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 shabash. Variable is nothing but it is a name. It is a name given to a one memory location.
Memory locations.
Which can hold a value. The value will be changed in future. The value will be changed in future. So what is variable? Variable is nothing but it is a name given to a one memory location. So for example, go, this is the memory location. It is a name. I'm giving one name, A. So it is a name given to a one memory location, which can hold a value. Which can hold a value, A equal to 10. That value will be changed in future number of times. So that time we can change the value at any point of time. If you want to change the value, you can change it. So variable is nothing but we can change the value. It is a name given to a one memory location, which can hold a value. That value will be changed in future number of times. How many times you want, that many times we can change the value. So that is called variable. What is the use of variable? One is reusability. One is reusability. Easy to update. Easy to maintain. These are the advantages. Reusability, easy to update, easy to maintain. So, syntax. Data type. Variable name. Equal to value. Simple, we can write int. Data type is int a equal to 10. Simple, we can write it. That is variable. Int a equal to 10. Data type, variable name equal to value. Int a equal to 10. Data type, variable name equal to value. Right. So, first of all, if you want to learn overloading concept, first of all, we should know variable. So, variable is nothing but it is a name given to a one memory location which can hold a value. That value will be changed in future number of times. How many times you want, that many times we can change the value. That is the variable. So, syntax, data type, variable name equal to value, int a equal to 10, right? Yes, today concept is overloading. Overloading means if at all a function more than one time in a class, like different arguments or number of arguments, if we write, then that concept is called overloading. Same function, if you write number of times in the class, so automatically it will show error. So if it is showing error or not, we can observe carefully. Just public static function I am taking here, public static void add function I am writing. So here add function I am writing, but differently. Now I am taking public static void, two arguments I am taking, int a comma into b. So two arguments I am taking here, sorry. So two arguments I am taking, int a comma into b. Into res equal to variable. How to declare variable? A plus b. Same variable definition only. Into data type. Res variable name equal to a plus b. S y s o control space. Res. Same function, if you write number of times, automatically it will show error. Common. Same function, if you write, automatically it will show error. So now it is showing error. Why? Because same function, if you write in number of times, automatically it will show error. But differently, what I am doing here. So I am changing the number of arguments. So first function, I am taking two arguments. Second function, I am taking three arguments. So it will not show any error. First function I am taking int a comma int b. Third function I am taking like double, different data type, double a comma double b. So same function, here I am writing number of times, but it will not show any error. See, first and second is example for number of arguments example. First and third is example for type of argument example. So same function I am writing number of times, but it is not showing any error. This is the concept of overloading. Overloading is the one of the concept provided by Java. What is the use of overloading? If at all a function more than one time in a class with different arguments, like type of arguments, comma, number of arguments, if we write, then that concept is called overloading concept. Same class I am writing number of times, but with different arguments or number of arguments. So that is the concept of overloading. Remaining is very easy. And so first function I want to call here. So 10 comma 20. So it will call first function. Okay, I want to call second function, add 10 comma 20 comma 30. So I want to call second function. I want to call third function, add 0.2 comma 0.3. All right. So if you write four values, for example, if you forget and you if you give 4 values, the time it will show error. So we declared only 3 arguments. If you write 4 arguments, automatically it will show error. So right, so we can call that function. Save, click on run. 30 0.5, what star? Something wrong. Wait, a plus b plus c. Save, click on run. 30 60 0.5, that is the concept. Okay, overloading concept is over, madam. Now I will ask you small question. Already you said something, you know Java, so that's the reason I am asking doubts or questions, just to try to understand. And first question, why we are writing void, madam? Already something you know about Java, so why we are learning Java? Why we need to write void? Why we need to write void? What is the use of void?
Void.
Why we are writing void? Sir, whenever you are writing any function, every time you are writing void. Why you are writing void? That's your question. My explanation is, void is nothing but I don't want any return value. That's the reason I am writing void, madam. I will tell you. I don't want any return value. That's the reason I am writing void. If I want to return value, in the place of void, we should mention the data type. Once if you mention the data type, automatically it will give the return value. Why I am writing void? I don't want any return value. I will tell you, madam. Don't worry. So here, this is the concept, but every time we are writing void, so I don't want void. So that means you need to mention the data type in the place of void. If you mention the data type, automatically it will give the return value. How it will give the return value, I will explain you. So just in the place of void, I am writing int, for example. So here is automatically it is showing error. Why? Because here is no need of this return. We should write return. It will give the return value. So void, in the place of void, I am writing data type int. So it is showing error. So I am writing return. It will give the return value. Void means I don't want any return value. That time we can write void. If you want a return value, that time we should mention the data type in the place of void. So void, I mentioned the data type. Here is double, we should mention here double. So it will give the return value. Just we should mention here return. Right, it will give the return value. So it will give the return value. That return value we need to store into one variable, and we can print it. So whenever you are comparing with void, that concept will be very easy. So but if you mention the data type in the place of void, that time we should take one variable, and we need to store, and we can print it. So it is very difficult, but not very difficult, it's very easy. But whenever you are comparing with void, that's the reason every time we are writing void only. Int x equal to, we need to store into one variable. Int y equal to, double z equal to, right, sy s4 control space x, sy s4 control space y, sy s4 control space z. Righty. Same answer, we can get here. same answer, but here extra we are writing in the place of void, we are writing data type 3060.5. But here you should remember one more point. So if it is integer data type, if it is integer, if it is integer data type, we can't pass decimal value. So with example, so it is showing error. It is showing error. If it is integer data type, we can't pass decimal value. But if it is decimal, if it is double data type, we can pass the integer values. But result will be 0.5, not 5. It will not give 5. It will give 0.5. Why? Because it is a decimal data type. That means it is a double. 5.0 it will give. That is the concept. If it is integer, we can pass only integer values. If it is double, we can pass integer values as well as decimal values also. That time, if you pass the decimal value, that time it will give, after value, it will give 0.0. That is the concept to overloading. So overloading concept, void concept, void and overloading. So it's very easy. Just once you need to practice, ma. So very, very easy. So this is the extra concept. Why we are writing void? I don't want any return value. That time we can write void. So if you want a return value, that time we need to mention the data type in the place of void. Once if you write the data type, it will give the return value. That return value we need to store into one variable and we can print it. So that is the concept of void concept. That is the concept of void concept. So easy.